Hello, in this video, I'm going to show you how to build HTML forms with radial buttons. So we'll cover the following topics. First off, I'll start off with a radial button demo. Then we'll look at the actual HTML code for building radial buttons. And finally, we'll pull it all together with a full JSP page example. So a lot of good things here. Let's go ahead and get started. All right, so here's the radial button demo. So we'll have the student's first name and last name, but now we want to have the student choose their favorite programming language. So here we'll give the first name and last name, and then they can go through and select their language, Java, PHP, C#, or Ruby. Once they have their favorite language selected, then they can go ahead and hit submit. And what we'll do is we'll actually generate a confirmation page with the language that they selected. So here I give the student's favorite programming language. In this example, the user chose PHP. So let's go ahead and look at the HTML here for radio buttons. You'll set up your input type of radio, and then you give the name, favorite language, and then the value, Java, and then an actual label for the user to see. And you repeat this for each one of the languages here, for C#, PHP, and Ruby. So the key here is that the input type equals radio, and that'll give you a radio button. All right, so let's go ahead and pull it together with an example. So we'll have a student radio form where the user will enter their information and they can choose their favorite programming language. They'll hit submit. It'll go across to a JSP page that'll actually process it and display the student's favorite programming language. Okay, and as you know, I love to-do lists here. So the first thing we have to do is create our HTML form. And then the second thing is create the JSP confirmation page. All right, so a lot of good things here. Let's go ahead and start coding. Okay, so let's go ahead and move into Eclipse. Just like all the previous videos, we'll continue to use the same project, JSP Demo. And also like the previous video, we're going to make use of the student form as our starting point, and we're going to simply copy it and rename it. So I'll just right-click on studentform.html. I'll select Copy. And then I'll right click on it and select paste. And when I paste it, I'm going to give it a new name. So the new name, I'll call it a student radio form.html. And once I'm happy with that, I'll go ahead and click the OK button. All right, so here's our form. Student radio form.html. Let's go ahead and double click this. Let's expand the window here for a second. And the first thing that we need to do on line 7 is just update the response page. So the response is going to be student radio response.jsp. All right, we haven't created that page yet, but that's where we'll actually send the data when we submit the form. All right, so a lot of this stuff is from before. But what I'd like to do is go ahead and enter the HTML here for the radio buttons. So I'll start off here with the favorite programming language. And then I'll set up the input type. So the input type equals radio. And the name equals favorite language. So that's the actual form field name. And then the value equals Java. So this is for this given radio button. And I also just put the label out there to the right. And now what I can do is just copy this X number of times for all of the other programming languages. So I'll just kind of speed the video up here real quick and just update it for C#, PHP, and Ruby. But now here's the end result. So basically we have four radio buttons here, and they're for each one of the different programming languages. And the key here again is the input type equals radio. Okay, so this looks good so far. So now let's go ahead and work on our JSP page. So again, we're simply going to copy our student response.jsp from the previous video, and we'll simply rename it. So I'll just right click, I'll choose copy. and then I'll do a right click and I'll choose paste. And for the new name, I'll call it studentradioresponse.jsp. And then I'll select OK. Nice. So now we should have a new page here, studentradioresponse.jsp. Let's go ahead and double click it and open it up. I'll expand the window here for a second. And let's go ahead and enter just a little line break here for it. And then I'll simply say the student's favorite programming language is X. And that'll be whatever the form data that was supplied. So here I'll use the $ curly brace, param.favoriteLanguage. And that's it. So it looks pretty good right now. So this will basically read the form field for param.favoriteLanguage. All right, so this looks pretty good. So let's go ahead and run this application. So I'll move over to our form, studentradioform.html. I simply do a right click. I choose Run As, and then choose Run On Server. Okay, great. So here's our form. We can enter the student's first name and last name. And then our new piece here is the actual radio buttons here. So they can choose either one of the programming languages, and then we could actually hit Submit. Okay, great. So here's our confirmation page. So here's the student's favorite programming language. And in this scenario, they chose PHP. But basically, that's the result of that form field, param.favoriteLanguage. So we're successful here in writing a JSP for reading that form field data. Okay, great. So let's go ahead and wrap up this video. In this video, I showed you how to build HTML forms with radio buttons, and then also how to write JSP to read that form data. Good job.